Hello, welcome to all for the day 3 class on this week. This class to analyze the need and importance of goods and services tax to the nation and also to discuss the benefits of GST to various stakeholders group. Let's see the importance of GST. The new reform of indirect taxation system in India, that is GST, is most favorable to the socio-economical sustainable development of the country in all the corner points. Here, we are discussing how GST is important to the country, so the importance of GST can be analyzed on different dimensions, such as the introduction of GST established the common unified national market, which attracts the foreign investments in the Indian business sector, and it will directly contribute to the promotion of Make in India initiative. The new indirect taxation is most essentially necessary to remove the major pitfall faced from an earlier taxation system, that cascading effect of taxes, by introducing the input tax credit facility, which can be claimed on the goods and services in each stage of the supply. GST harmonizes the indirect taxation system throughout the country by subsuming various taxes into one, and thereby it is minimizes the administrative burden to the government through unified laws, procedures and tax rates across the country. This taxation promotes the exports and the manufacturing activities in the country with the zero rate of tax of the exports. This generates the employment in the country and which will directly contribute on the growth of GDP rate of the country in the long run. By creation of employment in the country will indirectly eradicate the poverty through increasing the per capita income of the people. The opportunities created by the GST for foreign investors promote the good foreign investment climate in India. This will directly support government to undertake developmental projects in India. The introduction of GST minimizes the overall tax burden to the companies. This result in minimizing the prices of products, that will help the consumers to get their need products for their cheapest price. The GST minimizes the legal procedures to be carried in registering with tax authorities, filing of returns, claiming of input tax, etc., which enables the firm to comply with the tax regulation in an easy manner, and this will become an outcome of ease of doing business in India. GST removes the multiple taxes existed in India. This makes the country's tax into simple and uniform one across the country. This reform minimizes the recording keeping burden of the business organization in relation to various tax authorities, and this reduces the compliance and maintenance cost to the organization. GST eliminates the manual repetitive task involved in registration, returns, refunds, tax payments with automated procedures. All the interaction between the taxpayer and the tax administration is done through a common GSTN portal, which reduces the public interface and chaos. As all the stages are done through online, for example, all returns are filed online, input credits verified through online, which in turn results in better improvement of compliance environment. A greater assurance over taxation system is expected because there are common procedures for registration of taxpayers, refund of taxes, uniform formats of tax return, common tax base, a common system of categorization of goods and services is possible in GST. Important stages like obtaining registration, refund, etc. are all done at a faster pace. Customers are greatly benefited because there is a seamless flow of input tax credit between manufacturer, retailer, supplier of goods and services. This reduces the final price of the products. Large group of small retailers will be exempted from tax, or they will experience very low tax rates under a compounding scheme. Hence, this reduces the prices of products, and purchases from such retailers will benefit the consumers. The consumption rate will be increased as a result of low prices of goods and services, and this in turn helps to decrease of average tax burden on companies. Let's see GST implementation roadmap in India from 2002-2017. In India, goods and service tax was successfully implemented on 1st July 2017 after facing serious setbacks from 17 years through missing the implementation deadlines in many times. The implementation of GST had become India's biggest historical indirect tax reform. So, it is important to take a bird's-eye view on the GST implementation road map in India. Summary of this class. This class evaluated the need and importance of goods and services tax in Indian context by analyzing the benefits of GST to various categories of stakeholders such as government, which administers, levy and collect the tax in a smoother way, business people and consumers. This new tax minimized the various operational, regulatory and average tax burdens on each of this group of stakeholders.